Seoul, South Korea. A thriving city of 10 million that serves as the capital of one of the world's most dynamic countries. Over the last half century, South Korea has evolved as a significant player on the global economic stage and emerged as a burgeoning cultural mecca. It is a country steeped in tradition, with its sights set firmly on the future. South Korea's success is due to its people. Intensely focused with an unrivaled work ethic and an unyielding dedication to perfection. There is perhaps no better example of Korea's success than the world of sports. Never before has the world seen so many great athletes emerge from such a small country so quickly. Over the last 50 years, South Korea has quickly and quietly introduced the world to a new breed of athlete that is as unique as it is dominant. From figure skating to football, Korean athletes don't just compete, they commit themselves completely. This new movement in Korea is the direct result of a handful of individuals, remarkable athletes that have exploded on the world stage. As athletes, they have remained true to their dreams of success at the highest levels. As Koreans, they have carried with them the hopes of an entire nation. And as pioneers, they have blazed new trails for the future of South Korea. They are passionate competitors with a resolute dedication, an enviable work ethic, and an unwavering focus on excellence. There is a certain poetry to the success of South Korean athletes. As the nation rallies behind an individual, that individual inspires the nation, creating new athletes for the nation to propel forward. And every cycle has a beginning. The Berlin Summer Olympic Games, 1936. In the marathon, Son Ki-jung, a young runner representing Japan, was in the lead. He entered the stadium to cheering crowds with a lead of over 2 minutes on the nearest competitor. Ki-jung wins the Olympic marathon, but the victory is bittersweet. Son Ki-jung was Korean, and in 1936, Korea was under the rule of Japan. Since Korean athletes were not allowed to represent their country, he stood atop the podium with the Japanese flag at full mast, and the stadium filled with the sound of the Japanese national anthem. In silent protest, Son Ki-jung bowed his head and never looked up. Son was unable to truly represent his country, a painful moment for the fiercely proud Korean people. 52 years later, he would finally celebrate his victory with his countrymen. At the 1988 Summer Olympic Games in Seoul, the last torchbearer to enter the stadium was 76-year-old Son Ki-jung. It was a moment that brought tears of joy to an entire nation. These Olympics set a precedent for South Korea and its people, galvanizing the country with a new spirit of self-confidence. The South Koreans greeted the world with warmth and passion, creating a new appreciation for this small country. South Korea introduced itself to the world, and the world took notice. 14 years later, South Korea once again opened its doors to the world when it hosted the 2002 FIFA World Cup. And like 1988, the South Koreans proved to be gracious hosts while making it very clear they supported the home team.
Big screens were placed in the downtown areas. The Korean fans would come to the downtown 1 hour before kickoff, 2 hours before kickoff, take their place, sit patiently until the game started, and then the squealing would start.
You come into the stadium, you see all red colors. If they were an entire stadium, just red color. They had a big, big, huge, happy party during the World Cup in 2002.
Despite the enthusiasm of the South Korean fans, the South Korean team wasn't expected to be a factor in the competition. After all, no South Korean team had ever won a World Cup tournament game. There were some who felt that they qualified simply because they were the host nation. but no one seemed to have mentioned this to South Koreans.
I think the Koreans weren't so sure how their team would compete in the World Cup as hosts. They were a little bit nervous of the situation, and the expectations weren't so high. The turning point was the first game, a victory over the Polish national team, and the belief suddenly came into the country.
One of the young stars in that Korean national team was 19-year-old Ji Sung Park.
I was a very young player at the time when I was given the honor of representing my country at the World Cup. That in itself is enough motivation to perform well and do your very best. What I also found out is that the people of my country found happiness in watching us play. And that gave me great joy.
With a victory over Poland and a draw against the United States, the South Korean team next faced Portugal. And with the game taking place deep within the heart of South Korea, the Portuguese were at a distinct disadvantage. The 19-year-old rising star Ji Sung Park scored the game-winning goal, advancing South Korea out of pool play for the first time in history and establishing Park as the future of South Korean soccer.
The country exploded at that point. Park scored the goal, ran straight to the head coach, which was very symbolic, went straight to Goose Hiddink. He knew that was a turning point for his football career.
When I scored the goal against Portugal, it was one of the greatest moments of my life because all of South Korea was watching.
The tight-knit South Korean team, with the passion of the South Korean fans behind them, went on to defeat world powerhouses Italy and Spain to advance to the semifinal. It was there that their historic World Cup run would end, and they would lose a heartbreaking match to Germany, 1-0. For a team that until now had never won a game in World Cup play, the South Koreans defied their critics and instilled the team with a new sense of confidence. This success also launched the career of Ji Sung Park. As a member of the South Korean national team, Ji Sung has scored 13 goals. He has represented his country in 3 FIFA World Cups and captained the 2010 squad. Park is widely recognized as the best player from Asia.
Becoming a successful soccer player was a dream from a very young age. I knew what I had to do and what not to do to make my dreams come true. Since I was small, I had to become stronger, physically and mentally. My dreams were so strong that I had no choice but to focus on my goal.
In 2005, Ji Sung became the first Asian to play for Manchester United, a move which many would argue put him at the pinnacle of the sport.
The World Cup opened new opportunities to me. It showcased my skills to other countries. And because of it, I am playing for the most famous team in the world, Manchester United.
What Park has achieved with Manchester United, it's thrown the gauntlet down to any young Korean player. They know that they can go as far as they want to go. Anything's possible now for a Korean player, which was never possible before. Now they see one of their own pioneering for the next generation of Korean players.
22-year-old Chong Yong Lee is a noteworthy emissary of South Korean soccer's next generation. His career began in 2003 when he joined FC Seoul of the Korean Professional League. By 2008, he was also named to the South Korean national team. And in 2009, Lee followed in Park's footsteps to join the Bolton Wanderers of the English Premier League.
Ji Sung is one of the reasons why I got the opportunity to play in England. He showed that a South Korean player could play at the highest level.
Today, Ji Sung Park and Chung Yong Lee have joined forces as teammates on the 2010 South Korean national team. Together, they have helped elevate the level of play of the team. They are no longer a team that merely competes. They contend, raising the bar even higher for future generations. At a recent international match, Chung Yong Lee illustrated this confidence on the world stage as he put on an exhibition against the Ecuadorian national team. An apt example of how an individual performance is both assisted by and contributes to the overall team effort.